So, for history of plant cell cultivation, it began, as I said, the minute that cell theory came into the picture in parallel because of the world war going on. There were parallel discoveries happening in US and Europe. So, after the cell theory concept in parallel, then they also discovered the cellular totipotency in plant cells. So, that came in 1838-39 around. And then, so initial discoveries were what? The idea was to see if the explant can remain viable in the medium, can be kept viable for a longer time apart after taking it out from the plant. So, the attempts were to keep the fragments which were cut from the parent plant to keep them growing and viable. So, that were one of the. So, the idea was what kind of media would be needed to sustain that growth. So, therefore, then IAA discovery came. Wendt was able to find IAA, which is indole acetic acid, which is an auxin. So, then similarly, people were again focusing on coconut milk. So, initial discoveries you will find the media people used to use complex medium. So, there coconut milk was being used. So, when coconut milk was being used, they also, once auxin was discovered, they also found that, there is a component in coconut milk which is unlike auxin, but is able to support the callus growth. Then in parallel, they also found that how to induce from single cells, you can originate the callus. So, techniques of inducing callus, nurse tissue technique. So, what is that? They took a callus of some other plant and they had put a filter paper on top of that callus and let it be get wet by that callus. So, whatever came out of the callus was getting absorbed by the filter paper. And then on top of that filter paper, single cell was of carrot or I do not remember tobacco maybe or some plant, they added on that filter paper and they kept on observing it under sterile conditions. And they found that that single cell started dividing, multiplying, and then a callus was found to originate. So, these simple techniques of plant cell and tissue culture which form now basics of plant biotechnology, those were the initial discoveries which were very fast and very quick discoveries were happening in that and parallel. So, then it came on to further refined media requirements depending on what kind of culture you need. So, from single cells, then totipotency from carrot cells. So, initially the idea was to just maintain the explant and keep it viable. Then the callus induction came out. Then somatic embryos also came into the light by a simple experiment where the carrot discs were put in the suspension, and then because of the agitation, some of the single cells they got dispersed and came in the medium. Because of the nutrient composition present in the liquid medium, these single cells, some of these single cells rapidly divided and formed embryoid like structures with both primordiums, shoot and the root primordiums, later giving rise to the entire plant in the solid medium. That is how regeneration discoveries came into light. Then came agrobacterium mediated transformations, where people found that these natural vector systems can cause crown gall disease. Now, in these crown gall disease is when people tested the crown galls, they found that they have hyperauxinity. Hyperauxinity means that they did not require any hormones in the medium to continue their growth, and when detected, now all this detection also goes in parallel with the discoveries and advent of higher analytical techniques, microscopic techniques. So, everything was, lot of things were going in parallel and were being applied. So, then in this what they found in crown gall, that there was hyperauxinity, which means that there were genes present which themselves inherently producing auxins in large amount. So, that was one discovery. Then somebody also found opines present in these crown galls. Opines were nothing but they act as carbon and nitrogen sources is for the bacteria. So, when present in the bacteria, it does not get expressed. So, but once it infects in the plant cell, they get expressed and these opines start getting formed. So, which is then utilized by the bacteria as food source. So, initially these opines, because their expression was transient, then it was also found that their expression is not permanent, it is only transient. And so, initially they used to be used even as markers for testing successful transformations. So, these opines used to be used, but then later more foolproof confirmations were using PCR and your tDNA integration has happened or not. Then meristem culture also came into the picture. Now, why did people were looking, it depends on the objective to begin with and then the experiments designed to reach to that objective. So, now the objective was to see if virus free plants can be obtained. Now, for virus free plants, then people came with an idea of meristem culture. Now, we will be talking about in detail where in these meristematic tissues, if you use them for plant regeneration, then you find that they become free of viruses. It is an interesting question to think upon right now, how that why would a meristematic region would be free of virus and while the other matured parts of the plant are easily invaded by the virus. So, think about it, when we come to the meristem culture, then we will talk about it. So, then meristematic or meristem culture came into the picture for plant regeneration in order to produce virus free plants. Yeah. Then as I said initially in media, because people did not have an idea which critical nutrient or what nutrient is the most significant nutrient. So, people used to use complex media. In that people have also tried yeast extract, even now yeast extract is used. So, now then later with more refinement coming in people replaced yeast extract with found that vitamin B vitamins are also very significant in induction of in vitro cultures, plant cell and tissue cultures. So, then the yeast extract was then replaced by three of these vitamins, pyridoxine, thiamine and what else, nicotinic acid. So, then it was, so gradually all these then got better and better and more refined, well defined media compositions. Then White's medium came into the picture, which was specific to root induction. Then MS media till now it is used for callus induction. So, it is not only single MS, people even use half MS, MS by 4 compositions, which may impact the induction of in vitro cultures. So, now you know what is totipotency. Totipotency is the potential of the any plant cell to revert back and reprogram itself from a specialized function to its original and then re-specialize itself towards a different function. So, what is needed for a totipotent cell to regenerate into a plant is that the cell should be able to have an embryogenic capacity so as to form primordiums for shoot and root generation, and then there has to be a nutrient environment created around that cell to make the development of that cell as the cell is rapidly dividing in similar to what a zygote undergoes. So, then you will end up in having the entire regeneration entire into a whole plant. So, this is what I was talking about. So, this is how the entire plant came into the picture from using an explant, a disc of carrot which was suspended in the liquid. Some of the free cells, because of the shaking, became free in suspension, and these cells and the media which was used was favorable for embryoid formation. And then those totipotent cells divided with embryogenic competence. They start dividing. As they divided, they reprogrammed and started behaving like embryoids, and then leading to shoot and root primordium, and then after transferred to the solid medium, it gave rise to roots and the entire plant.